Hello and welcome to a festive update from the world of the royals. As Christmas nears, homes are being adorned with sparkling lights and trees, and the rush for last-minute gifts is in full swing. Amidst this Yuletide cheer, let's delve into the current state of affairs with the Duke and Duchess of Sussex, Prince Harry and Meghan Markle, and their holiday plans, or rather, where they won't be spending their Christmas. Recent reports, particularly a piece from the Mirror Online dated November 13th, headline with Prince Harry and Meghan Markle won't reunite with royal family for Christmas amid feud. This news might not come as a shock to many. Given the tumultuous relationship between Harry, Meghan, and the rest of the royal family, especially post their controversial statements and actions, it seems highly unlikely that they would be part of the traditional royal Christmas at Sandringham. The article's timing is noteworthy, coming right before King Charles's birthday and amid rumors of a phone call that may or may not have happened. It appears Harry and Meghan were testing the waters, perhaps hoping to exert subtle pressure on King Charles about their Christmas plans. But, as we've come to expect, their actions and intentions often become the subject of public and media speculation. The dynamics within the royal family, especially between Prince William and Prince Harry, have been the focus of much discussion. Reports of William's strong feelings towards his brother add another layer of complexity to any potential holiday reunion. The question that arises is, how could Harry and Meghan realistically consider joining the family at Sandringham after all the upheaval? In conclusion, while the exact whereabouts of the Duke and Duchess of Sussex for the holiday season remain uncertain, what seems clear is that their Christmas will be spent away from the traditional royal family gathering. Continuing with our royal holiday narrative, let's dive deeper into the ongoing saga of Prince Harry, Meghan Markle, and their speculated Christmas plans. It seems the couple might have harbored hopes that a public outcry over their children missing a traditional English Christmas with the royals could sway King Charles to extend an invitation. This theory aligns with their alleged need to remain connected to the royal family, perhaps as a means to sustain their relevance and access to royal insider stories. Commenting on this complex situation, Richard Fitzwilliams shared his insights with GB News. He remarked, "I suspect there is a mixture of emotions there. That will certainly not change now. They have no base in Britain. Things have reached that stage. It's not good. The rift means there is no such possibility at the moment." His views reflect the deep-seated issues within the family, highlighting the improbability of a reconciliation in the near future. The impasse continues, with reports suggesting Harry is holding out for an apology that seems unlikely to come. The royal family, particularly Prince William and King Charles, stand their ground, believing they have done no wrong. Conversely, Harry and Meghan, often perceived as unyielding, are unlikely to concede either. This deadlock suggests that the feud is far from resolution. The question of whether Harry and Meghan would be welcomed at Sandringham for Christmas looms large, especially considering they reportedly weren't even invited to King Charles's birthday. Speculation abounds that a Christmas invitation could boost their public image, particularly for Meghan. Imagery of her joining the royal family for the traditional Christmas church walk could be a public relations win. However, the likelihood of this happening seems slim, with opinions suggesting that Meghan's motives are transparent to the royal family. As we continue to follow these developments, The Mirror has recently published a new article. In the latest twist in the royal Christmas saga, Meghan Markle seems to be reshaping her strategy. According to a recent exclusive from The Mirror, Meghan appears to be taking a different stance, indicating relief over not spending Christmas with the royal family after what some perceive as a snub. This marks a notable shift from her usual approach, veering away from the victim narrative to an attitude of indifference, seemingly expressing, "Well, I didn't want to go to your stupid Christmas anyway." Such behavior prompts criticisms about her maturity, with some commentators suggesting that her real motives aren't familial affection or a desire for reconciliation, but rather financial and professional gains. Meghan's connection to the royal family, as some argue, remains her most significant asset in these areas. Luella Alderson, a relationship expert, offered her perspective on the matter. She suggests that Meghan may not be keen on reconciling with the royal family, considering her experiences with them and the British media. Alderson believes Meghan might view this as an opportunity to further distance herself and focus on her life in America. According to her, Meghan might feel a sense of relief at not having to confront the royal family or return to the UK soon. the tension between Meghan and other members of the royal family, particularly William and Catherine, is a point of constant speculation. Remembering Meghan's demeanor during the Queen's funeral and the subsequent walkabout, some interpreted her expressions and body language as discomfort or reluctance to be in that situation. Critics often point out that while Meghan is vocal about her standpoints, her actions, especially in high-pressure situations, seem to contradict her outspoken nature. This behavior is seen as indicative of her awareness that key members of the royal family, like William and Catherine, are not easily swayed by her narrative. As this complex royal drama continues to unfold, Meghan's current attitude and future actions remain a subject of keen public interest and speculation. In the latest developments surrounding Meghan Markle, it appears she's more inclined to maintain her distance from the royal family. Critics argue that Meghan's choice to stay away from royal engagements and Christmas festivities may stem from a reluctance to confront the consequences of her actions. Some perceive this as a strategy to avoid accountability while continuing her narrative from the comfort of her Montecito home. Luella Alderson, known for her insights on relationship dynamics, offers a different take. She suggests that Meghan's priority might be her mental health and family's well-being. According to Alderson, regardless of her feelings, it's likely that she wants to prioritize her mental health and well-being as well as the happiness of her family. For Meghan, this could mean keeping their distance for now and reconciling when all parties are ready for a genuine and positive reunion. This perspective hints at a possible future reconciliation, albeit under more favorable circumstances. However, there are those who question Meghan's understanding of happiness and her motivations. They argue that her actions don't align with someone genuinely seeking happiness or reconciliation. Instead, they see her as someone more focused on personal gain, often at the expense of others. The possibility of Meghan and Harry making amends with the royal family seems increasingly remote, especially considering their past actions and public statements, including those made in their docuseries, Harry's book, and the Oprah Winfrey interview. These have not only strained their relationships with senior royals like the Queen, Prince Philip, Prince Charles, Camilla, and the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge, but also have impacted the public perception of the couple. As this narrative continues to unfold, the role of their PR team in shaping their public image becomes more prominent. The release of various statements and articles paints a picture of a couple attempting to navigate their complex relationship with the royal family and the public, raising questions about their ultimate intentions and perceptions of reality. As the saga around Prince Harry and Meghan Markle's relationship with the royal family continues, some wonder if their strategy of using media statements to express a desire for reconciliation will bear fruit. The question arises, do they genuinely believe that public declarations will compel King Charles and Prince William to extend the apology they seek? However, the issues preventing Harry and Meghan from joining the royal family for Christmas festivities seem to go beyond mere retribution for past actions. There's a growing sentiment that their presence could pose a risk, especially to Prince William and Catherine's children. This concern stems from some of Harry's past comments, including the notion of being one plane crash away from the throne and his perceived duty to protect his niece and nephew from the burdens of royal life. Moreover, Harry's public criticisms of his stepmother, Camilla, particularly in his book, have not gone unnoticed. His harsh words have led to questions about his motivations and desires to spend time with the family he has so openly criticized. The paradox of Harry and Meghan's actions also raises eyebrows. Their apparent eagerness to reconcile with the royal family, despite their vocal criticisms and the lucrative opportunities their royal connections afford them, paints a complex picture of their intentions and goals. As we ponder over these developments, the question of Meghan and Harry's real motivations for their Christmas plans remains a topic of intense speculation and debate.